Hey friends, my name is George Gennaris. I'm a chef of 36 years, and if you're here, it's because you like to eat healthy, save money, and cook like a pro. Except today, we're not going to be eating healthy. Today, we're just going to push health a little bit to the side. We're going to nourish the soul, and sometimes that's more important than nourishing the flesh. Today, we're going to have shrimp kataifi, which you probably never had before. You should. It's delicious, it's elegant, it's beautiful, it's an awesome presentation. Stick around. So what is kataifi? Kataifi we call often shredded phyllo dough, but it really is not shredded phyllo dough at all. It's made similarly to a vermicelli, very, very fine strips, kind of like a bird's nest. You buy it frozen in a typical Greek or Turkish or Middle Eastern store. It does find its roots in the Middle East. Mostly it's used for dessert. Today, we're not gonna use it for dessert. Today, we're gonna make shrimp kataifi skewers. And I deeply regret not inventing this dish because it's right up my alley. This is the kind of thing that I would create, but someone else created it. Oh. One of the things I like to do is to make garlic salt. It makes for a great seasoning, and I'm gonna use it in this dish. The problem with purchasing garlic salt from a supermarket, obviously the first problem is that it's probably gonna be crap salt, and secondly, it's probably gonna be crap garlic. But most importantly, it's very salty. So I make my own, and I make it by weight. Now the salt is gonna be heavier than the garlic, so you wanna start out with the salt, and I've zeroed my container on this scale. I'm gonna measure it out in grams because I find that with grams it's a little bit more accurate. Later on, I'll switch it to ounces so you can see. It really is irrelevant. Whatever you use, whatever measurement you use, grams or ounces, you just wanna make sure that the parts are equal. So today we're gonna pour in some really good quality salt. This is real salt from Redmond. You can use a good quality Himalayan salt. I'm gonna put in this container 50 grams. I went a little over, it's 54 grams, not the end of the world. Let's just make sure that we put in 54 grams of granulated garlic or garlic powder. Now you can use either one. I find that garlic powder tends to be less expensive, so your personal preference is not gonna change the flavor of the recipe. So let's put in our granulated garlic here and get that up to 108. Okay, 108, 109, not gonna make a big difference. And if we want to switch to ounces, we'll see that we've basically made 3.8 ounces of this product. Close the lid, give it a really good shake. Instant garlic salt. Now, one of the things that may happen with this garlic salt that you've made is it may get sticky in the summertime, especially if you don't use like one of these containers that are airtight. But to combat that, you'll use like a desiccant that's food grade. Put a link to it down below. It's available on Amazon. Just pop one of these in there and now you're good to go. And you could use this a lot. You could use it to season butter. You could use it to season any kind of food. You could use it really what it's intended for, which is pizza. And just keep that in there like that. And you are all set. Food safe, great product. And that's what we're gonna use today. I'm gonna start out by melting 1 pound of butter. And that's excessive. You probably won't use a pound or 450 grams of butter or 4 sticks of butter, but I don't wanna run out. And if I do make extra, it's okay. I'll just let it cool off in the fridge because I plan on using it in the future. This butter that I'm gonna use to prepare this dish, I use for a lot of different other recipes. So I'm not worried about having extra in my refrigerator. Now, while my butter is melting on the stove, I'm gonna peel my shrimp. You take the tails off. We're gonna be passing these on a skewer. These shrimp are wild caught. They're known as U15, or actually these are 13 to 15, which means that there are 13 to 15 shrimp per pound. So I'm using 2 pounds here, or 900 grams, roughly 908 grams of shrimp. They're big shrimp. You can put 2 on a skewer, you can put 1 on a skewer, you can put 3 on a skewer. Basically, it all depends on how you plan on serving it. Obviously, if you're gonna serve it as an appetizer, you're gonna probably use 1 shrimp per skewer, and you're gonna use smaller skewers. Let's start out by rinsing our shrimp in a bath of water and then straining it out. You wanna finely mince 1 clove of garlic, a nice beefy clove of organic garlic per pound, or 450 grams roughly of shrimp. We're gonna add our finely minced cloves of garlic to our shrimp. We're gonna add 1.5 teaspoons of granulated garlic salt mixture that we made earlier to this mix, which is roughly comes out to about 3.5 grams per pound or 450 grams of shrimp. We're gonna add 1/4 cup of a good quality Sauvignon Blanc to this, which comes out to about 60 milliliters per pound of shrimp, or in this case, we're gonna put a half cup. We wanna season this with a good couple of turns of a quality ground organic black pepper. And we're gonna add the juice of a good quality organic lemon here, or half an organic lemon, to this almost kilo of shrimp. Finally, we're gonna take our butter that we have melted on the stove. We're gonna take a tablespoon or 15 milliliters to the shrimp. That's per pound, or 400 and some odd grams. So basically 2 tablespoons or 30 milliliters to this batch. Ideally, we want this to marinate in the refrigerator overnight, or at least a couple of hours. And to our butter here, we're going to whisk in 2 tablespoons of our granulated garlic mixture, or 30 grams. I don't recommend that you use a clarified butter when doing this, because you're always gonna have to continuously stir it. There won't be any suspension of the salt in the oil. This kataifi phyllo dries out very quickly, so when you're not using it, you better cover it with a wet towel, otherwise it's gonna become a disaster to work with. You'll never get it to roll. In this little bowl here, I'm gonna put my sesame seeds, and I'm going to use 2 different types of sesame seeds, white and black. You don't really need to use the black sesame seeds. You don't really need to use the white sesame seeds. You can use either one if you want, doesn't matter. But if you do use white and black, the way I'm gonna use it, I recommend that you do like a 3-to-1 ratio of white to black, because the black sesame seeds, you just wanna kinda accent the color. They're not gonna really change the flavor of the dish, but if you put too much black sesame seeds, it's gonna look a little weird. So I'm just gonna put 3-to-1 ratio here of white to black. Now we take our phyllo dough. Here's the interesting part. You don't want to try to use long strands of this stuff. You just want to take a section of it off and kind of pull it out like this into like a clump, okay? Basically separating the different strands of phyllo from one another. And you'll get an idea based on how many shrimp you're going to put on the skewer of how much phyllo to use. And you want to create a nest on the cutting board or the surface that you're prepping on. You don't want to leave too many blank spaces. And so my shrimp is gonna have to land somewhere here, like this. And I've created an even pile of kataifi phyllo here without too many spaces. You take one of these silicone brushes, you're gonna wanna mix up the whey, the milk, and the butter, and the garlic that you have here. And you just wanna drizzle it pretty liberally all over the kataifi phyllo in drops like that. You take your skewer, you put your shrimp on the skewer, try to keep it as straight as possible. Doesn't matter if the little tip kinda sticks out like that, that's fine. Try to go straight and try to do it in one pass, because usually you won't get a second chance. Pretty much the shrimp gets shredded by the skewer itself. It looks like 2 shrimp are gonna work. Now I wanna leave room for my guests to hold this, so I'm gonna slide this up a little bit like that, leaving a longer tail on the skewer. And you simply rest it onto your kataifi phyllo and just roll it like that. Really simple. Try to gather up as much of that kataifi as you can, just like that. And that is exactly what we want. Finally, you take your butter and you brush it on top. So it's kind of, it's a very buttery dish. It has a lot of flavor, and you want to finish it with your sesame seeds right on top like that, and you're good to go. Serve this with an Asian flair. Take 1 cup or 240 milliliters of coconut aminos, and to that add 1 tablespoon or 15 milliliters of rice wine vinegar, 1 tablespoon or 15 milliliters of sesame oil, and 1 teaspoon or 5 grams of chopped chives. I wouldn't serve this with any sauce at all, but it does go really well with the coconut aminos and the sesame oil. If you are going to serve this dish, I recommend you serve it plain. And if you want to complement it nicely, serve it with a saucy vegetable like a stewed eggplant with tomatoes and onions or something like that. Basically, I prepared 12 skewers here. Now, can you prepare them in advance? Absolutely. If you do, I recommend that you prepare them and keep them on the pan that you're gonna cook them in, because once that butter solidifies between the kataifi phyllo and the pan, it's like a glue. When you pull it off, the kataifi phyllo will definitely stick to it. Keep it in the refrigerator, cover it with saran wrap. When you're ready to cook it, put it in the oven at 400 degrees. It's going to take about 9 minutes. It's about 204 degrees Celsius. And when it's golden brown, it's done and ready to serve. Can you serve it later on? I don't recommend it. It'll be a little funky, but you could let it sit for as much as 20 minutes. Let's give it a try. I'm gonna have it plain. It's such a wonderful dish, so elegant. Very simple. Just with a little drizzle of coconut aminos. That'll rival any tempura dish you've ever had. It's delicious, it's simple. Give it a try, leave a comment down below. Hit that subscribe button if you like this video. Show your appreciation by hitting that like button, and I will see you again very soon.